So what's this all about then?
The NPC meme.
NPCs are non-player characters in video games. Instead of being controlled by humans, they're controlled by artificial intelligence. Their actions are all predetermined by their coding, making them appear robot-like, formulaic, repeating the same movements and saying the same things over and over again. Walking cliches, just unconsciously repeating the same glib mantras. Now, who could that possibly remind you of?
Believe all women. Believe in something, even if it means sacrificing everything. Refugees welcome.
But the left has struck back. They say the NPC meme is dehumanizing. Oh my god, so dehumanizing.
NPC meme is dehumanizing. We are all unique and special.
Remember, these are some of the same people who call anyone to the right of Joseph Stalin a Nazi. Oh, but now you care about people being dehumanized. Cry me a river.
Anyone unironically using the term NPC in reference to anything other than video games is automatically a Nazi in my book.
When we're not being demonized as the new Fourth Reich, we're being belittled and dismissed as Russian bots.
NPC is a fascist term to dehumanize us. Everyone right of center is a Russian bot. Does not compute.
I assume whoever began pushing that meme was looking to further dehumanize their opposition by linking it to the in-game NPC players that are easily killed. Someone is pushing for a civil war. Russia, I assume.
Civil war? The f*** are you talking about? It's a meme. It's not the Battle of Fort Sumter.
Stop it. Get some help.
They also slapped it with the dehumanizing label to try and get it banned because Twitter recently said it would ban people for using, quote, dehumanizing language. So again, even in the process of denying that they're NPCs, they act like NPCs in advocating for a sterilized internet where edgy banter is verboten. But maybe these NPCs really aren't human. Maybe they just like basic bitch social trends and banal popular culture as a default effort, as a way of just trying to blend in. After all, what else could explain the success of The Big Bang Theory and How I Met Your Mother? There's also this weird disconnect where they dismiss NPC as a pathetic playground insult not worthy of attention, yet then write laborious article after article after article being triggered by it. The same thing they did with soy boys. What happens to kids who react to playground insults? They get the same insult thrown at them again and again because it obviously gets under their skin.
Immediately stop following and retweeting anyone using an avatar like the one pictured below. These are 4chan trolls impersonating resistive. I keep seeing this garbage all over my feed tonight.
The NPC meme gets under the left's skin because it's mostly true. The left has mainstreamed a culture of ruthless ideological intolerance. The left has completely rejected diversity of thought. When Taylor Swift tells everyone to vote Democrat, it's an admirable call to action. But when Kanye merely suggests that black people think about not voting Democrat, he's ridiculed and called insane.
Hello, I am a comedian on the television. If you disagree with my politics, you must be mentally ill.
You lot literally tell husbands and wives to divorce each other if their partner isn't a Democrat. You openly advocate the breakup of families for, God forbid, having different opinions to each other. You lot reduce anyone of a certain skin color to be mandated to hold certain political opinions. And then if they don't, their very existence is deemed hateful. How is that not dehumanizing? If that's not the very essence of being an NPC, then what is? Is their favorite news network MSNBC? Or is it this one? Is their favorite TV show? Is their favorite comedian? Is their favorite politician? Is their favorite political commentator? Is their favorite celebrity?
Hello, fellow humans. I am celebrity number 2932. I believe in everything that is safe and popular with people aged 18 to 35. You may now praise me on the social media platform of your choice. Remember to purchase my newly manufactured album.
Here's a visual representation of how Twitter works.
I agree. Agreement with each other's views means we are right and the other side's evil hatred must be stopped. Well, I got all of these accounts suspended, but why do I still feel so empty and pathetic?
Here's the Krasenstein twins. Here's their arch enemy.
Black not equal Democrat. System error.
Here's God only knows what this is. And here's what happens to anyone who suggests that maybe Trump isn't the new Hitler.
Rape is bad. Orange man is bad. I'm
I'm still waiting for someone to tell me what I am outraged over today. I follow such a diverse range of people, and for me this is what Twitter is all about. Get out of your echo chambers and start listening to unique and individual voices. I agree with whatever Twitter terms of you says I should agree with.
As Evan James writes, the NPC meme is a response to something real, something that snarky liberals and even leftists increasingly fail to notice. In short, it is a tragicomic acknowledgement that things are not okay, that we are all NPCs to one degree or another because we're all in bondage. The NPC meme lampoons our tendency to consume the products of mass culture precisely because they are easy to process, requiring neither personal effort nor prior learning. Serious cultural engagement requires focus. It nevertheless has a rejuvenating effect, whereas the passive consumption of mass culture leaves us more enervated than before. And the same goes for political opinions. It takes a modicum of research and a small step beyond superficial thinking to understand that no, not everyone who doesn't have hashtag FBPE or a blue wave in their profile is an alt-right neo-Nazi. And no, Donald Trump isn't leading America into a dystopian nightmare where the planet's oceans boil over and women who have abortions are sent to concentration camps.
You are fake news.
Everyone freaked out over the EU planning to ban memes. Twitter is already banning NPC memes and the accounts of people who post them. Oh, you can make your avatar a Trump orange or a Cheeto all day long, you're not gonna get banned. Of course, we all know why the left wants to ban memes. Because the left can't meme. That's not just a cliche. They admit to it. A study undertaken by researchers at University College London found that the most effective memes largely originated in two places, the Donald subreddit and 4chan. A Vice write-up of the study acknowledges that the most, quote, effectively spread memes originated on the Donald and Poll. That's why they want to ban the NPC meme. Not because it's dehumanizing. They dehumanize us at every available opportunity. They want to ban it because it's effective, and they have no adequate way of responding. Because they can't meme. They can't meme because memes incorporate edgy humor. Oh my god, so edgy. The left is incapable of edgy humor because they're always walking on eggshells. They're always terrified of offending someone. That's how they ruined comedy.
This meme's dead now. You talked about it. You kill more memes than PewDiePie.
Shut up. As I've explained before, with facts and evidence, I don't kill memes. I send them into space. I'm the SpaceX of memes.
Give people more credit.
I've killed fewer memes than the amount of Native American DNA in Elizabeth Warren's blood. So yes, the NPC meme is funny and effective because it's mostly true. That's why they hate it. That's why, with the midterms just a few weeks away, and with the walk away movement growing, the NPC meme freaks them out.
Infowars.com